It's a pleasant day to all of you. I'm Queen Darlene and welcome to P6 for Engineers. It's a pleasant day.
How will you measure a plane angle? How about the height of a tree? How about the dimensions, elevation, shapes, and contours of sides? They have different measurements, so they need different measuring tools or instruments. And today, together with my groupmates, we will discuss to you the different instruments used in measuring angle and direction. But before anything else, let me introduce to you first the definition of angle and direction. And today, together with my groupmates, are you ready? Are you ready? Let's start. Let's begin with the word angle. The word angle comes from the Latin word angulus, meaning corner. Cognate words are the Greek word angulus, meaning crook or curb, and the English word ankle. Both are connected with the Proto-Indo-European root ang, meaning to bend or bow. An angle is the figure formed by two rays called the sides of the angle, sharing a common endpoint called the vertex of the angle. Angles formed by two rays lie in a plane, but this plane does not have to be a Euclidean plane. It is used to designate the measure of an angle or of a rotation. This measure is the ratio of the length of a circular arc to its radius. Angle also provides a means of expressing the difference in slope between two rays meeting at a vertex without the need to explicitly define the slopes of the two rays. Let's begin. According to Bruni Ware, an Australian author, different angles reveal different worlds. Perspective is a choice. Without further ado, let's proceed to the definition of direction. In physics, when we talk about direction, we consider a segment of a straight line connecting two points in the space. It is from initial or the first point to the final or the second point. In other terms, it is also defined as the path that something takes, the path that must be taken to reach a specific place, the way in which something is starting to develop, or the way you are facing. According to Oliver Wendell Holmes Sr., an American physician, the great thing in this world is not so much where we stand, as in what direction we are moving.
Hi, I'm Maris, and I will now proceed to the discussion of instruments used in measuring angles and directions. The most common device to measure angles is the protractor. It is used to measure small angles and sometimes big ones too. It is a useful device in construction, engineering, and architecture. There are three common types of protractor. The first one is the commonly found in almost all stationery stores. A half circle protractor would mark the crease from 0 to 180. It measures small angles with 180 and 90 degrees, and it is used by students in schools and colleges. The other one is the full circle or round protractor that have 360 degrees, which is more useful to professionals. The last one is the bevel protractor, an angular measuring instrument capable of measuring angles with at least count of 5. The protractor dial is graduated in degrees with every 10 degree numbered. The sliding blade is fitted into this dial. It may be extended to either direction or set at an angle to the base.
Hi, I'm Marian. Let me discuss to you the other instruments, which are the hand squares and compass. Hand squares are also some of the devices used to measure angles. These are used in measurements of larger angles as they have degrees from 0 to 360. In cases where there is construction of stairs, frames, and rafters, framing squares are used to measure right angles as they usually L-shaped devices. They are also used if you want to know how to measure square feet. Other than this, the set squares, which are used by students to study their academic geometry in mathematics, are also great. Next is drawing compass. A drawing compass is a hinged set of arms wherein one arm has a pointed end and the other holds a pencil. It is used to measure and construct angles in a quiet, easy way because it can rotate into complete 360 degrees of a circle. When you have a circle in which you want to create angles, a drawing compass helps measure them, as you can simply keep one end in any particular point and with the pencil end. Measure the distance. When you have the distance, all you have to do is to place the drawing compass on a square or on a protractor and measure the angles. It is important to measure the area of the circle too on the paper.
Hi, I'm Lara Melissa Shane Tumbok. Do you still enjoy our presentation? Because at this moment, I will discuss you the following instrument. Hi. Let's start with the drafting triangles. The drafting triangles, usually made of clear plastic, are used to measure angles and draw vertical inclined lines. There are two common types available, the 45 degree triangle and the 30 by 60 degree triangle, are named by the size of their acute or small angles. The 45 degree triangle has a 90 degree angle and two 45 degree angles, while the 30 by 60 degree triangle has a 90, a 30, and a 60 degree angle. Drafting triangles are available in sizes ranging from 4 to 18 inches. Let's start with the drafting triangles. The drafting triangle is usually made of clear plastic, are used to measure angles and draw vertical inclined lines. There are two common types available, the 45 degree triangle and the 30 by 60 degree triangle, are named by the size of their acute or small angles. Adjustable triangle. Combining the function of protractors and drafting triangles, adjustable triangles can be set and locked at any angle. The degree of angle, marked in half degree increments, are found on the protractor portion and then locked in place. The triangle portion can be used to draw a selected angle.
And now it's my turn. Hello, I am May, and today I will talk about some more additional instruments regarding angle measurement. For first is the multi-angle ruler. The multi-angle ruler has been designed to measure a variety of different angles with precision. It is effortless to use and is very efficient. This screw can be used to tighten and loosen the arrangement with ease. The ruler can be used for a lot of purposes. It can be used to create specialized angles, shapes for stones, bricks, wood, laminate, and much more. You can create bull eyes, lab cuts, and any other professional projects. And the next one will be goniometer. A goniometer is an instrument that either measures an angle or allows an object to be rotated to a precise angular position. The term goniometer derives from two Greek words, which is gonia, meaning angle, and metron, meaning measure.
Hi there, this is Justine, your presenter for this moment, and I will introduce to you the other instrument. First on my list is the clinometer. Clinometer is a tool to measure the angle of elevation or angle from the ground. In a right angle triangle, you can use a clinometer to measure the height of tall things that you cannot possibly reach to the top of, including flagpoles, buildings, and trees. Next is the slope indicator or inclinometer. A slope indicator or inclinometer is an instrument used for measuring angles of slope, elevation, or depression of an object with respect to the gravity's direction.
Hello everyone, I am Jerwin Insumahit from BSCO A1A. I will discuss to you the following measuring tools and instruments. I will begin with the transit theodolite. The transit theodolite are used by the surveyor to measure both horizontal and vertical angles. While the purpose of the two is similar, as a general rule, a theodolite is more accurate than a transect. However, there is no specific rule as to when one definition ends and the other begins. Generally, these instruments have a minimum accuracy of 1 minute of angle, and some very precise theodolites will measure angles to an accuracy of 1/10 of a second of angle. To put these accuracies into perspective, at a distance of 1 mile, 1 minute of angle covers about 1.5 feet. At a distance of 1 mile, 1/10 of a second of angle covers about 0.003 feet. Lastly, the angle indicator. An angle indicator is used for measuring angles from 0 degree to 90 degree in two directions. And that's all.
To finalize our discussion, let me introduce to you the last but not the least among the list of instruments. It is the compass. A person uses a compass to determine the direction of a line. The compass needle points to the magnetic north pole, and by turning the compass in the direction of the line being surveyed, the direction of the line can be observed. Although there are many varieties of compasses, they all fall into two main categories, either a plane compass and a vernier compass. A plane compass has no adjustment and always reads magnetic north, while a vernier compass has an adjustable scale
that allows for the setting up of the magnetic declination, and the compass can then directly read true north. It is the compass. This is the end of our discussion. Together with my groupmates, we want to thank all of you for participating and listening.